In this segment, we're going to see how we can use vectors to write simultaneous linear equations. So let's suppose somebody gives us m linear equations with the equations with the n unknowns. So somebody is giving us m linear equations with n unknowns. So let's suppose those are like this, a11x1 plus a12x2 plus all the way up to a1nxn equal to c1. And then we go to the last equation, which will be, because we're given m linear equations, it will be m1x1 plus a m2x2 plus up to amnxn equal to cm. So we are given these m equations and we have n unknowns. And how can we write these in the vector form? You can very well see what I can do is as follows. I can say that, hey, I'm going to write this one as the, I'm going to put one vector equal to another vector. That's what I'm going to do first. And I'm going to, in this vector, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these as the entries. I'm going to put a11x1 plus a12x2 plus all the way up to a1nxn as the first entry. And then I'll have my second entry, third entry, and the mth entry will be am1x1 plus am2x2 plus amn xn. And then here I'll have c1 all the way up to cm. So that's what I will have there. So what I've basically done is that somebody gave me m simultaneous linear equations, and I'm now putting them in the vector form, where this is one column vector is equal to another column vector, which I simply get from because those are the right-hand sides of those equations. But you can very well see that I can break it down further by saying as follows, that I will put down in my first column as a11 all the way up to am1, and I'm going to multiply it by x1. Because all of these are multiplied by x1, so I'm going to put my a11 in a21 and so on and so forth up to am1 and multiplied by x1. Then I can have x2, and those will also be multiplied by a vector which has m entries in it. So it will be a12 all the way up to am2. And I can keep on doing this till I have xn, and that will get multiplied by a1n all the way up to m entries there, amn, and that will be equal to c1 all the way up to cm. So what you're finding out is that if I call this to be, let's suppose, a1 vector, I call this to be the a2 vector, they're all column vectors, I call this to be the a3 vector, and I call this to be my c vector, what I'm finding out is that, hey, I'm getting x1 times a1 plus x2 times a2 plus xn times, I shouldn't call this a3, I should call this an is equal to the c vector. So what you're finding out here is that I'm getting a linear combination of n vectors multiplied by x1, x2, all the way to xn equal to the c vector. So what that means is that if I take a linear combination of these n vectors and I put it equal to the c vector, and if I'm able to find the solution to this linear combination of these n vectors equal to the c vector, then I have found the solution, because that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for the values of x1, x2, all the way to xn. So when you're looking up this set of equations right here, what I forgot to mention was that everything is known here, including the coefficients a11, a12, and so on and so forth, and these right-hand sides. The unknowns are simply the x values, x1, x2, all the way up to xn. So if we are able to find a combination for the scalars which satisfy this linear combination equal to c vector, we have found the solution. So that's how we write, we can use vectors to write simultaneous linear equations. And that is the end of this segment.